Namaste, Periyava Saranam. Three great devotional hymns. The World Mother has been sung and worshipped in the form of Lalitambiga by many a great sage and many a great poet. She has many other forms too, like Durga, Kali, Annapurneshwari and Bhuvaneshwari. Sri Mahaswami speaks about Lalitambal alone. Lalita is worshipped as Rajarajeshwari, Kamakshi, Kameshwari and Tripurasundari according to the Sri Vidya Tantra. The Lalita Sahasranamam, the Lalita Trishati, the Lalita Ashtotra and so on contain the different names of Lalita, the supreme deity of Sri Vidya. Among the songs in praise of Lalita, three are preeminent. The Arya Dvishati by Durvasas, the Panchasati by Mukha and the Saundarya Lahari by the Adi Acharya. In chronological order, the Arya Dvishati comes first, followed by the Saundarya Lahari and then by the Panchasati. The Saundarya Lahari thus occupies a central and commanding position among the great devotional hymns. The authors of these three works are our own. They are closely related to us and are especially connected with Sri Kamakshi, the presiding deity of our Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham. It was Durvasas who created the manual of worship for the Kamakshi temple. Puja is performed even today according to this manual. Everyone knows the Acharya's connection with the Kamakshi and the Kamakoti Peetham. Mukha became a poet through the grace of Kamakshi, and the hymn he has composed in 500 stanzas is in praise of her. The Arya Dvishati is the oldest of the three. Dvishati means 200. It is so called because it has 200 stanzas devoted to Devi. It is composed in the rare meter called Arya. Besides, the subject of the hymn is also Arya, that is Ambal. Arya is the name of Ambal. Our Adi Acharya's mother was Arya Ambal. The devotional poem of 200 stanzas by Durvasas, apart from being in the Arya meter, is in praise of Arya, that is Ambal. So its name Arya Dvishati is appropriate. It is known by another title, Lalita Stavaratnam. It means a gem among the hymns adoring Lalita. It is customary to refer to Ambiga as Bhattarika. That is why three of her outstanding devotees have each the title of Bhattarika. One of them is Ishwara himself. He is referred to as Paramasiva Bhattarika. Another is Mahakavi Kalidasa. His literary genius and poetic muse are ascribed to the grace of Mahakali of Ujjaini. He is the author of the Shyamala Dantakam and the Navaratna Mala, which are in praise of Ambal, and he is referred to as Shringara Bhattarika. In one Bhattarika is God, another is a mortal, a poet. There are two categories, Ghana and Lagu, weighty and light. A God is Ghana, a mortal is Lagu. There was a Lagu Bhattarika who composed the Panchastavi consisting of five hymns to Ambal. There is a view that Kalidasa, who was a Manushya Bhattarika, was also called a Lagu Bhattarika. It is customary to speak of rishis as belonging to a category separate from those of the celestials and mortals. Sages like Narada were Devarishis born among the gods. There are numerous examples of rishis belonging to the human race. Whatever the category or race an individual belongs to, if he grasps the timeless mantras pervading space in a subtle form and presents them to us in a form audible to us, he must be said to belong to the special category of rishis. In Vedic rites, there is one in which tarpana is offered separately to the gods, the rishis and the pitrus. Among the three Bhattarikas, since Ishwara is a god and Kalidasa was a mortal, would it not be appropriate if the third was a rishi? This third Bhattaraka was Durvasa's. Among rishis, he was one who received the grace of Ambal in full. He was called Krodha Bhattaraka. Thus, three Bhattarakas, Paramasiva Bhattaraka, Sringara Bhattaraka, and Krodha Bhattaraka. Durvasa's is the first belonging to this world to have composed hymns in praise of Ambal. Apart from the Jusati, he composed another devotional poem to the glory of Ambal, entitled Shakti Mahima Stotra. That Ambal manifested herself in this speech would be evident to those who read the Jusati. The greatest blessing that Ambiga bestows on her devotee is the gift of speech and eloquence of a high order that is employed in extolling her, in portraying her in various ways and experiencing bliss in it. It enables a devotee to give expression to the bliss he delights in, thus making it known to others and enabling them to share in it. Ambiga blessed a dumb devotee with the power of speech that could be said to be without bounds. We do not know his real name. He resided in the Kamakshi temple, and we know him as Mukha, meaning one who is dumb. The moment he received the grace of the goddess, he brought down a shower of not just 200 stanzas, but of 500 in praise of Kamakshi. In Mukha's Panchasati, the first 100 stanzas are called the Arya Satakam, and they are in the Arya meter. The second 100 depict the beauty of the lotus feet of Kamakshi and are aptly called Padaravinda Satakam. The third 100 verses extol her greatness revealed in many ways and constitute the Stuti Satakam. The fourth 100 portray the goddess's sidelong glance and are called the Kataksha Satakam. And finally, the fifth 100 stanzas describe her gentle smile and comprise the Mandasmita Satakam. Thus, the 500 stanzas in all of the Panchasati, the Arya Dvishati and the Mukha Panchasati are like the work of an inspired painter. They bring before our mind's eye a portrait of Ambal. What is not accessible to the eye and the mind is brought so close to us. Periyava Saranam.